Hey everyone, this is Andrew Worsnop. I'm the head of maths at Education Perfect, and today we're going to talk about NAPLAN practice tests. All right, we've got four NAPLAN practice tests for you. All of these are linked to practice resources for them as well. I'll show you what our tests look like, I'll show you how to set them, and most importantly, I'll show you how to look at the results and how easy it is to set further work based on that for your students. All right, so when you log into your Education Perfect account, this is the page that you will see. If we want to preview our tests, we can just go over to the purple browse content button here. Okay. The exact folders that you see here will depend on what school you're in, but everyone should have a proficiency tests folder, and this is where our NAPLAN practice tests live. Okay. We have one of each type of NAPLAN test for year 7 and year 8. All right. So one each of calculator and non-calculator in year 7 and year 9. When you go through and see, I want you to go in have a look because we put a lot of work in to make sure that these tests match the exact style, tone, and difficulty of the NAPLAN, the actual NAPLAN tests. So you can come in here and see these tests before you set them with your students. All right, just like a real NAPLAN, because we want to provide that match to the real NAPLAN experience, you've got 32 question tests in 40 minutes, just like a real NAPLAN. You can log in right now with your own account and go through this and see what's in our practice NAPLAN tests. What I'm going to show you now is how to set them. All right, so a NAPLAN practice test is a type of assessment, so we'll go into the green button here. We'll click New Assessment. And remember, for maths, the NAPLAN practice tests are a type of proficiency test. So we're going to click this button over here. All right, this is the exact same thing that you normally see when you're setting an assessment. It just means when you click what test you want to set, it's automatically going to take you to that proficiency tests folder, all right, which remember is where our NAPLAN practice tests live. All right, I'm not going to actually set an assessment now because hopefully you know how to do that. If you don't, please just get in touch and we're very happy to help you. But what I want to get to is actually showing you what the results look like after your students have sat it, and how easy it is to get students sitting further work to actually, which actually means they improve. We're not just setting a test and seeing their results, we're actually giving them a program to increase their knowledge, okay? So this is what you see when you click through. This is a past test, a practice test that I've put for a demonstration class. We can see how many students completed it, their average mark, the distribution of their results. When we go down, this is providing student results for each student. If I wanted to see an individual student's answers, I can see that by clicking View Details. But the real bit I want to show you here is this table. This is where the magic happens. All right. What we've done is actually taken all our questions and tagged it against what topic it belongs to. And some of the questions belong to multiple topics. What we can see is for the whole class, what topics and what areas they need more help with. So I'm looking, 3D shapes, they're doing a lot worse than other topics. Estimation and rounding, that's another one where I know I probably need to go over a bit more. And relating descriptions to algebraic expressions, that's, you know, our students apparently need a lot of work there, which might be fine because they're only year sevens, might have not much exposure to algebra yet. But what the point of this is that all of these are linked to lessons that students can go do. So it's not, like I said, it's not just about a summative assessment of what they know and don't know. We can actually give them individualized practice resources to help them improve. All right, and these are all lessons just from our normal curriculum. The real magic in this, you can see this, the real magic in this is how easy it is for you as a teacher to set purely differentiated work, purely individualized work. We're going to do that by clicking this button here. All right. When I click Assign Tasks, every student's going to get the next step that they need to take set for them as a lesson, right? So that the system actually works out what the easy and hard lessons are. And if a student has got a lot of the easy sections, they don't get assigned that. They get one of the medium or hard lessons. If a student is not doing very well in a place like fractions, but they're doing better at percentages, it's not going to give them percentages, it's going to give them fractions, all right? So it's really individualized work set automatically by the computer for you, all right? There are some settings you can play with here if you want to go into more details. If you don't know much about this and you'd like to know more, please just get in touch. We're happy to have that conversation. I hope this has given you a nice overview of what's on offer for our NAPLAN practice resources, and I hope your students have a good go when that all happens in a few weeks. Thanks very much.